Welcome to the WinCC step-by-step tutorial created by Bob Meets at iQuest. This tutorial is designed to lead you through creating a complete project with WinCC version 7.4 using all of the basic editors. During the course of this tutorial, you will learn how to create and manage a WinCC application. You will learn how to connect to your process using tag management, where we will load process drivers for Siemens PLCs, as well as OPC UA connections, system info connections that get information from Windows, and internal tags that we'll use with the color process that we'll be building. We're going to introduce you to the new WinCC Configuration Studio that also allows you to create and manage alarms, tag logging archives, as well as security with users, groups, and authorization levels. You'll also learn to write functions and Visual Basic scripting and to call these scripts from the process screen. We will also learn to use the WinCC Report Designer, where you will learn to create report layouts and print jobs that give us insight into our process. Now let me take a moment to show you the runtime application that you will create with this tutorial. Here we have our main screen with navigation buttons across the top, an alarm banner, some custom buttons for our alarm control, the name of the current screen being displayed, as well as logon scripts and display of the currently logged on user. On the overview screen, we're going to learn to create template control pop-ups with tag prefix so that we can control our color components. We'll also use some of our gradient objects to give our UI a more realistic and appealing look and feel. On our detail screen, we're going to create faceplates and then use them for each of our color components. These are global objects so that a change in one place will result in all of these objects being updated no matter where they're used in the project. We're going to create an admin screen that displays the system information we're getting from our sysinfo channel, like time, date, CPU and RAM utilization, and how much space we have left on the hard drive. We'll also show you how to create a button that calls other Windows applications, such as the Windows calculator. We'll show you how to preview and print reports that you create in Reports Designer. These reports include snapshots of the current window, as well as a list of active alarms and alarms archived during the period of the shift, as well as an output of the trend control during the period of the shift. We'll also show you how to build comprehensive alarm screens using the WinCC alarm control so that you can see historical as well as current alarms. And we'll also show you how to build the trend control to show process archives and use the ruler object to be able to see instantaneous values of a trend, as well as to do some analytics based on a time period. Finally, we will show you how to implement security, create a login button that calls the system dialog, and add security to controls so that operators cannot perform actions that they're not authorized to do so. So if you're ready to get started learning about WinCC, go to the next section and we'll begin with creating your first WinCC project.